Okay, now we have our bunny, kind of gone through the work to bring him to life. It involved a bit of typing to get there. But next, we want to start to leverage some of what makes regl nice with its declarative interface, with its access to StackGL, and the way their opinions mesh really nicely together. And we want to use glslify. So if you haven't seen it before, it's on GitHub, and it is a wonderful way to bring in npm to your ecosystem, to your shaders rather, the npm ecosystem to your shaders. There you go. And in order to set it up, the first thing you do is required in. There are multiple ways to set it up, but this is the way I would recommend. And I've required it in now. And what I need to do is modify my package JSON to add this browserify transform glslify, and that will handle wiring it up into browserify for you. And then what I ended up doing is I call my, rather than calling it glslify, I just call it glsl to simplify it a bit. And I go down to my template tag and I put it in front of there. So this is a tag template string, I guess is the name for it. And I have this magic thing set up in my editor where once I have this keyword in front of it, my editor knows how to syntax highlight that string. And I've done that through this Language Babel plugin. And there's this JavaScript tag template literal grammar extensions. And I do glsl colon source dot glsl. So it's a handy way to write it all in line, keep it all in one place, and not lose your mind by not having syntax highlighting. I didn't for a while, and I eventually got to the point where I was like, oh yeah, this would be nice to have, and figured it out. So that's my trick of how I do it. So now we have access to npm, and handily I've installed a module called simplex noise, and I've got a snippet set up so I don't have to type the glslify syntax because I always have to look it up. And I also have another snippet if I'm doing it from scratch. I can do r tab. I've configured it to then let me type it that way. But you can see here I have my require command, which is my module, and then this has multiple directories of the specific function I want, which is simplex noise 40. So this is a four-dimensional simplex noise. Okay, so let's start to use it. So we're gonna use our old trick from before and set up a second position because this position in is not changeable. And we want to set to use it as our output. Let's go ahead and save, make sure we didn't mess up. And then our position two, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to plus equals some simplex noise on it. And this takes a vec4 as the input. And if I just save this like that, it'll break because I didn't put a semicolon. And it'll break again because I did something else wrong. Let's see what it is. Boop. Position to plus equal. Constructor does not. Oh, let's set a value in there of 0. Now it's not breaking. So setting it in with just a simple 0, 0, 0, 0 vector doesn't do anything, so we need to provide a more interesting input, which I can feed the position into. Let's go do position 2 and set the fourth dimension to mysterious 0 value. Let's save, and now you can see, okay, we've got a little bit of noise of what's going on. But we've also got our normal, so I can apply it in the direction of the normal. So now we have a spiky bunny that's doing things. And I'm going to start putting this into multiple lines so it's a little bit more readable. It gets spiky really quickly, so let's go ahead and multiply by 0.5 to scale that noise out a little bit. 0.3, 0.4. There, that's a nice bumpy bunny. So my next trick is to go back down here. If you remember, we have our time, which I moduloed to 1 to keep it within the range of 0 to 1. I'm going to go ahead and just set it to just the time. And I'm still bringing that in. I'm going to set up this fourth parameter as time. And now you can see, let's go ahead and see that a little bit larger. And let's move me out of the way. Okay, come back in. So you can see we've kind of started to be able to play around with the values. We've done some of the more traditional aspects of things that like 3JS make really easy are like, let's create a box and put it in our scene graph and then define a camera and render it. These are great abstractions. But if you want to dive into some of the more algorithmic side where you're actually playing with more of the math, this lets you get a lot closer to that and lets you leverage some of the ecosystem to do it. And it's part of why I like regl. And I hope that if you're interested in this, this inspires you to start to create some interesting data-driven visualizations, to read up on math and all the kind of crazy crap you can do with it. Because for me, like it's kind of a passion thing. I enjoy playing around with the math and talking with people about it and making cool visualizations with it. And for me, regl is a really nice fit for that type of workflow. It's a little bit more math nerdy, I feel like, in the way it's designed, but also done in a way to make it just fun and easy to use. And I think for my next video, what I'll do is I'll show you some of my sessions and how I start to organize some of these files to get some more practical examples of how to scale this idea of how you use this type of architecture.